After watching this tutorial, you're going to be equipped with the skills and confidence needed to generate more awareness and more walk-ins for your local business using Facebook ads. My name is Paul Raimondo, and I'm here to run you through a Facebook ad tutorial for your local business so you can generate more awareness and more foot traffic using Facebook ads. Make sure you stick around to the end because it's going to be a bonus tip regarding exclusion targeting for specific geographic areas that not many advertisers know about. So for today's example, we're going to be using a fictional restaurant called Paul's Restaurant. Paul's Restaurant is facing a hypothetical dilemma right now. They do wicked bookings. Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Monday even. But on Tuesday nights, they hardly get anyone in. It's a pretty slow night of the week. We want to target people in the local geographic radius around Paul's Restaurant with some kind of value incentive offer to get people to come in at the slowest time of the week on Tuesday nights. Now, even though this is a fictional restaurant and a fictional ad that we're creating today, it's important to remember that these same principles will apply to whatever local business you're running. Let's hop in. Here we are in Ads Manager, and what we wanna do is just go ahead and create a new campaign. So we'll hit that green create button there. We'll give it a name, Paul's Restaurant, a Tuesday promo. All right, and now what we wanna do is go down to campaign objective and click on store traffic. If you haven't set up your business as a local Facebook page, then you're not gonna have the option of being able to run a store traffic campaign objective. You're not gonna be able to run get direction call to action ads, and it also means that you're gonna have a bit more trouble getting the results in which you're trying to achieve. And then we wanna go and select our Facebook page. I always recommend starting with a low daily budget, so we're gonna go ahead and just change this to $5. For the ad set name, I like to make it related to the audience. So let's go people within 5 miles. And then the ad name is gonna be based on what the creative inside that ad is. We're gonna be using Entree Special promo. So that way, when you hop into your campaign, you can see, okay, cool, the campaign name is Tuesday promo. The ad set name is targeting people within 5 miles. And the ad name specifically is Entree Special promo. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and hit save to draft. We're gonna go through to the ad set and open that up. Click edit. We're gonna go through and choose our store page here, and then we've got a store set. It's very, very important that we have your local ads set up correctly from your business manager and from your Facebook page before you hop in and run these ads. When you do it correctly, you are able to then choose all of the stores in their respective locations. So let's just choose this store, for example. And now what we wanna do is go down and finish building out our targeting. So 22 to 35, and we're basically targeting an area around the store set. Let's say that you don't already have a local store set up inside of Facebook. What you can do instead is go down to here and target a geographical area instead. So this is now targeting Australia. I've gotten the actual physical location of the geographic area which I want to target in Western Australia. I'm going to go through in here. Now you'll see that it's put a radius around that address's store. Now you can change this targeting from anywhere between 1 mile up to 50 miles. If I was to run too wide of a targeting, 5 miles, it's going to be very ineffective. So I want to make this as small as possible. Let's move that down to 1 mile. We can see that our potential reach is 27,000 people. I want to change this to manual placements. This is gonna be a time sensitive offer that we wanna run during our least profitable time. I wanna run this on Tuesdays, and I wanna run it to people that are on their mobile phones in the geographic area of our targeting recently within that time frame. If I was to put, say, someone's laptop as a placement or newsfeed on desktop as a placement, probably not gonna be as effective as targeting people on their mobile devices. I'm gonna go down to all devices, recommended, unclick desktop. Now it's only gonna show up Facebook newsfeed, Instagram feed, marketplace, and stories. For the purposes of this tutorial, I'm gonna be ignoring stories as a placement, but if you'd like to learn the best tips, tricks, hacks, and how-tos with regards to running Instagram ad stories, go ahead and click the link above. Now you can choose to run your ads to people living in or recently in the location, people who just live in the location, people recently in the location, or people traveling in the location. I'm gonna be choosing people that are recently in this location. So the last thing we need to do is set up the budget and schedule for our campaigns. Now, Facebook's always constantly adding and removing features. In a perfect world, I'd be able to add a budget and schedule for this in this area of the ad set and only run it on Tuesdays from say 11 a.m. through to 6 p.m. If you have the ability to customize your delivery, please do it. However, for the purposes of this example, I'm gonna run this for 2 weeks in that geographic location, which will be a great test because it's gonna allow us to stay top of mind and relevant in our target audience's minds. Okay, so now that that's done, X out of here, and we can hop into the ad level. I'm gonna go through and edit the ad that we're setting up. We've got our Facebook page for Paul's Restaurant selected here. Then you also wanna select the relevant Instagram account. So we'll go through and select Paul's restaurant. There's this new feature here where you can customize the ad voice. You can customize it whether it's coming from, say, your big page or whether your local, it's your local page. So I'm just gonna choose the main page as the ad voice and go through and set up our ad, which is super simple, single image or video. Then we're gonna go through and go add media, add image, upload an image which I prepared earlier. Now we have the beautiful image of this entree. Okay, so here's some creative and copy I prepared earlier. Enjoy any of our award-winning entrees for free when you dine with us between 6 p.m. and 8 p.m. on Tuesday nights. Simply mention this Facebook post to your server to claim. Now, one of the biggest challenges a lot of my local business clients face is tracking real-life conversions from a digital spend. Because there's no pixel in real life, it's really hard to work out which ad led to which conversion. So one way you can do it is just go on super old school, super analog, and this call to action here. Simply mention this Facebook post to your server to claim, and then getting your actual servers at the restaurant in real life to note down, cool, tonight we had 5 people mention the Facebook ad. The conversion rate for that would be 5 conversions as a result of the ad spend for that night. When you've got your Facebook local pages set up, you can actually choose the Facebook location street address and the location city from the back end of Facebook, which is dynamically populated. Now, here comes the fun stuff. What I want to happen when people see this offer in their newsfeed is click get directions in the ad, directing them from their current physical location through to the restaurant itself. All you need to do is click open in map as your destination. And because you've already pre-populated all of your local business information with Facebook Ads Manager in the back end, it's gonna automatically populate your address inside of the ad. Okay, so here we have the final ad with the get directions call to action button. We wanna just double check that the Facebook pixel is on. And then it's just as simple as going ahead and pressing the green publish button and seeing how your first test works at a low daily budget of $5. Now that we've published the ad, the last thing we wanna do is just double check that everything is correct. So I've just hopped back into the ad set level and realized that I left the name of the ad set at people within 5 miles. Obviously we chose to make it 1 mile only. So I'm just gonna go through and change that ad set name to within 1 mile. Double check that the ad looks the way that you want it to look. If you wanna see what it looks like in the Facebook feed, click this button here, go to Facebook post with comments, and this is what it looks like, the completed ad. And you'll see how this bit here has been dynamically populated with the address locations. And then obviously you wanna make sure that the directions are working correctly, and you can do that by clicking get directions, which will fire up a map in your browser and double check that that is actually leading people to the correct store. Because the last thing you wanna do is spend all this money on ads and then direct them to the wrong location, all right? Double and triple checking your work is very, very important before you go ahead and finally go back into Ads Manager and activate the campaign. Now you think that we're done, but let me tell you, fam, we've got some more exciting stuff in store. Let's say that you run this ad for like 2 weeks. You're getting really decent impression, really decent reach, but the ads just aren't converting. It might be because your location mapping is off. What we can do is actually exclude areas from our targeting inside of the ad set so that we have more of a relevant targeted audience area when we're running our ads. Oh, it's so fun, let's do it. We go back into our ad set area and we click on the edit button. And now we wanna go down to the locations that we're targeting. This is actually a shopping center, right? So what you wanna do is zoom in. Now this is the actual shopping center. So let's say that we only want to target the people that are actually physically inside this shopping center and this store's location. But how do we do that when the maximum radius that we can target is 1 mile? Well, we use these exclusion pins. So we drop a pin, drop it anywhere in the map. What you wanna do is drop it, say, here. That's gone through and added a pin at this latitude and longitude. We're gonna decrease the pin size to 1 mile, like this. And then we want to click this drop down button here and go exclude location. So now that you can see this red radius area, and you can see this Venn diagram here, it's excluding this audience from being targeted. And then all we have to do is simply go rinse and repeat. Okay, so here is the finished result. You can notice that as I zoom in, all of these areas around the outside are excluded, and we're only targeting that nice little blue Venn diagram area in the middle. Now you also notice that the potential reach has gone from about 27,000 people down to 12,000 people. If you have a really highly populated area, this is fantastic. However, if it's less densely populated, this may not be the best strategy for you. So the other really cool thing about this strategy is that you can use it to target your audiences wherever they may be at a certain point in time. So think about events. Let's say there's a baseball game going on next weekend, and you're a bar that's located close to where the baseball game is. You can run ads promoting, say, post-game happy hour to everyone attending that baseball game in that geographic location in an effort to drive more foot traffic and awareness of your bar to a relevant audience that's ready to drink. Okay, now that we've successfully completed our Facebook local ad setup, we might wanna learn how to target them to Instagram story ads. My colleague Susan has the perfect tutorial for you, which I recommend checking out right now.